Welcome to all, myself Professor Deshmukh MS presenting the theory lectures based on friction wear effect on the surface. So what is the first? That is friction and wear. So friction is quite easier. It is resistance to the motions. That is called as friction. What about the wear? It is a progressive, or you can say it is a process of progressive removal of material due to the friction. That is called as wear. So what is the basic difference between friction and wear? Friction, it is only the resistance which create the restrictive oppositions to the motions, or restrictive force against applied force. That we call friction. What about wear? Wear is the entire process. Wear is the entire process which is used for removal of material from the surface. What should be the total effect of this friction and wear on the surface? That we have to see. Look at here, that is a friction, corrosion and that of wear. So these three are being eliminated. That is by the three, that is technique, that is surface engineering techniques. So friction, we are already discussed. Corrosion is what? That is a rusting formation in presence of air. That is called corrosion. The friction, corrosion and the wear are most common factors which cause the engineering failures. In the industry countries, 7% of the GNP, gross national product, represent the cost of friction. Cost of friction, wear and corrosion, with possibility of 1% of this figure. Now figure show that a sea water corrosion damage the shaft without coating. So with the possibility of 1% of this figure being reduced through the use of efficient tribological system on the worldwide of all lubricant produced or consumed in Europe, with 50% of this being recycled, okay, with the future 2.5 million tons being lost in the environment. So corrosion is mainly an electrochemical phenomena which occurs when metals react with materials in their environment. Figure shows that corrosion damage of shaft without proper coating. Corrosion coats in UK and USA are approximately the $30 billion and $276 billion everywhere respectively. On the basis of the corrosion and the wear respectively, the corrosion, that is a wet corrosion, without stress, that is uniform atmospheric galvanic pitting corrosion, with stress, that is stress corrosion, corrosion fatigue, erosion corrosion, stress corrosion, cracking, hydrogen embrittlement, then corrosion again, high temperature corrosion, that is oxidation, sulfidations, halogen corrosion. Now we are again having the different types, that is the abrasive wear, adhesive wear, corrosive wear and erosive wear. Now wear is already discussed, that is progressive loss of material from the surface. So what is abrasive? When there is the contact between two surfaces and another material will be added in that, that material create the friction, because of which they are get engaged, that is called, and when there is, we are applying particular force, one surface get removed by another, that is called abrasive wear. Now adhesive wear, adhesive means what? There is a welding of material, that is a wear. Then are again adhesive, there is a welding is happen between the two parts, there is pressure exist, and that of your corrosion, that is a rusting formation. Erosion, when we are applying particular force over some distance, that is called as what? The abrasive, that is called as what? Erosive wear. So this is all about the corrosion and wear effect over these conditions. Quite easier one to understand the concept.